So what the expertise that we developed here is solar resource mapping in desert environments. So you know that different research, big research center and government agency like NREL in the US, like DLR in Germany, they are very active in solar assessment, solar resource mapping. But our what we are doing here different is the solar assessment in desert and dusty environment. So we are dealing with dust in the atmosphere, so the amount of solar radiation that we receive in the ground is much less than we have like clear sky conditions, and also the accumulation of dust over the panels. So how we can model the transport of aerosols in our climate here, and how we can integrate this information into our solar assessment. And the other, we have another team working on the solar technology, how you can estimate or assess the efficiency of solar panels in such environment. Because the efficiency can decreases with temperature. We have very hot temperature in the summer. How we can find the best technology that are more adapted to the climate here, to the region, the UAE, and also we are now looking at more larger scale and regional scale. So we have collaboration with different government agencies here in the UAE and also Saudi Arabia, with Qatar. Also we include Qatar in our mapping, so we are covering whole Qatar. We are producing like high resolution maps each 15 minutes. We are getting data about we are getting about like 1 to 5 terabytes of data from satellite every week. So we are processing the data. We are archiving data here, and also we have an agreement with IRENA. So we are managing the Global Atlas application here. So all the Global Atlas maps are stored at our research center here, and we have two engineers working full time for IRENA to process data from different countries and integrate them in the Global Atlas applications. So the center here is about, we have 15 scientists, postdoctoral level researcher in atmospheric science and earth observation, solar technology. And we have about 6 research engineers working more in the IT development, high performance computing, solar technology simulation, and so on. And also we are getting data from the 10 megawatt that we have here in Masdar City. It's the real case study. So we are measuring the efficiency of those panels in real environment, so how the performance is, because we are measuring solar radiation and we are measuring the power. Agreement with the Saudi KA Care, so we are be extending our mapping to the whole Arabian Peninsula for solar mapping in the desert environment, and this is what attracted KA Care to team with us and work together for the extension of the mapping of solar potential over Saudi Arabia. So Saudi is a large country. It's 28 times the size of the UAE, so even the computing size. So we are assisting them in setting up their own real-time satellite system there, because we went through the same exercise before, and then real-time monitoring of solar resources and also integration of solar simulation tools over Saudi Arabia.
And this information is easily accessible by anyone? The mapping and
it depends. The maps, the monthly and yearly maps are available to the public. We are sharing them through IRENA Global Atlas interface. But the higher resolution one, more simulation tool are more for stakeholders.
Yeah.
Or because we do also assessment in detail, in-depth assessment studies that we do it for different developers that are interested to implement their solar project in the region. Yeah. You know, the Saudis announced like 42 gigawatt by 2032. It's a huge. For us, the 7% BOE is about 1.5 gigawatt. We just started. We have like 300 megawatt installed so far. But, you know, like 42 gigawatt for 20 years, it's a huge. So we have a lot of investors coming to the region here interested in solar potential to understand the climate, how their technology and be reacting and performing in the region here. Because they need to understand, have some measurements. So we are testing different technology here in our test field, measuring the performance of power output under different environmental conditions.
He was just saying that there are a lot of models developed to evaluate solar resources have been developed in Europe and North America, and they're developing them for this desert environment because there's a huge effect from dust that limits solar resources. And that's not really accounted for in the previous models. So they've developed these for the UAE, and they're working now with about doing that for Saudi Arabia.